Welcome to Prime News with me, Angela. Let's take a look at the Prime News of the day.
Rajya Sabha MP Shantaram Naik condemns attempts by BJP to saffronize education. Claims Goa AIIMS is a bogus BJP promise. Entire Zika investigation sabotaged by diverting the attention on the missing file, Churchill Alemão and Digambar Kamath, says United Goans Foundation. Then opposition leader Manohar Parrikar had said that abortion cases had gone up in Panjim in view of casinos. Have these cases stopped? Asked Generation Next.
Now the news in detail. If BJP discloses the name of the chairman of the new Education Policy Formulation Committee, its conspiracy to saffronize education will be exposed. External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj fears that she is the next victim of Narendra Modi's systematic finishing of top leadership.
Firing around on many issues concerning the central BJP government, Rajya Sabha MP Shantaram Naik said HRD Minister Srimati Irani should disclose why she visited RSS office to get feedback on the new education policy. He said that Sushma Swaraj admits of the record that LK Advani, Murali Manohar Joshi and now Vasundhara Raje Chauhan and she were being targeted since all were prime ministerial contenders. Naik was addressing press conference in Panjim on Tuesday.
From heart to heart, she is blaming her own leaders. She says in privacy that two leaders, they have already finished. Indirectly meaning, they shall not name. Indirectly meaning, Advani ji and Murali Manohar Joshi. And she feels that she is the next target.
Labeling Goa's AIIMS as a bogus promise, Naik also said that AIIMS has not been approved for Goa. He questioned who will pay for 112.86 acres of land for NIIT. 50% of the cost should be got from the central government since land cost itself will go into crores of rupees. Naik also said that no architectural plan had been prepared for the three-star hotel cum convention center project at Farmagudi Ponda.
Setting up of AIIMS in Goa is not yet approved. However, this may be considered in subsequent phases. Right now, there is no sign of this hospital coming. Now, who will pay the cost of this land, which will come into crores and crores of this, in view of the new Land Acquisition Act? Normally, I understand it is state governments who have to provide land to national projects. But I would like to appeal to the central government and also ask state government to demand at least 50% of the cost of land acquisition of this proposed NIT project in Kumkuni. I'm saying only 50%. I don't say give us full, because 50% of the purchase price, when land will be acquired, purchase price will have to be paid to the owners. So state government must get at least 50% of the cost on the central government.
For Prime, video journalist Praveen Marathe, Panjim.
The government has sabotaged the entire Louis Berger JICA investigation by diverting the entire attention on the missing file, Churchill Alemão and Digambar Kamath, United Goans Foundation has said. The NGO also accused the BJP-led government of a huge cover-up for using the crime branch as pawns to tailor the case politically. beginning a sustained initiative to expose how the trajectory of the Louis Berger JICA case was being diverted, United Goans Foundation attempted to peel the layers of the now politically managed scam investigations.
Number one, look at the speed of the investigation. In just 2 days, a report was prepared, and within a short time, a few days, arrests were made. We have a feeling that Parsekar knew what was going on in the US, the fact that this trial was going on, and that is why he was able to take such quick decisions.
The United Goan Foundation has raised several questions over the state government and the JICA investigation being carried out by the crime branch instead of CBI.
On the 1st of August, if you realize, Manohar Parrikar made a statement. He said that this issue is just, it's not even the tip of the iceberg. We all understand Manohar Parrikar. He will not shoot off his mouth if there's no truth in it. And we are the little constituents of Goa who are smart enough to take these messages he sends out. So we have taken that message seriously because we take Manohar Parrikar very seriously. And true to his word, I'm saying, once we started collating on the data, we have realized that it is still not the tip of the iceberg, like the way he said. So, in a way, we should be on behalf of United Goans Foundation, we thank Manohar Parrikar to actually lead us down this lane.
The NGO said that the investigating officers are not clean and are doing the inquiry. The United Goans Foundation said that there is a huge cover-up happening in the investigation and people will lose faith in the judiciary.
One is not going all the way and the other by not starting itself. While this government has started on the road to truth, the attempt seems to be half-hearted, partially true, and hiding quite a few facts. Over the next 5 days, the UGF will explain and ask questions about this JICA scam, which basically has been arising in the minds of a lot of Goans who share the common concern about Goa and also Goa's and India's reputation as far as the whole world is concerned. Why was it that he didn't advise Parsekar to go for a CBI inquiry? Now, getting to Vacha Sundar. Now, Vacha Sundar, considering the fact that he was involved with the JICA from day one, should have been the prime suspect. Then how did the CM Chief Minister make such a horrible mistake and ask the prime suspect to actually appraise him of the case initially? The raids on the house of Vacha Sundar were conducted nearly after 10 days after the news broke out. Enough time for someone who's got access to all files to do whatever he wanted.
For Prime Video journalist Saif Sheikh Panjim. Margao citizens have demanded the resignation of Margao Municipal Council Chairperson Arthur De Silva over his alleged involvement in the infamous Louis Berger bribery case. They said that De Silva's involvement in the case has brought shame and disgrace to MMC. Meanwhile, anticipatory bill has been granted to MMC Chairperson Arthur De Silva. The special public prosecutors raised no objection to grant bail to De Silva. Citizen Croydon Madeira demanded that De Silva should step down as the MMC chairperson as he has been summoned by the crime branch in the JICA scam case.
He has brought international shame to the Margao Municipal Council in this particular JICA case, since it is an international company. The crime branch should, in tandem with the income tax department, raid his places and find out where this money has come, how he has amassed so much of wealth in such a short time, okay, from the day he arrived from Karwar into Goa. I would request and demand, in fact, today that Arthur immediately resign this very week, okay, to keep up his promise with what he had said some months back. This only goes to show the people of Margao and Fatorda that this particular council headed by Arthur De Silva has brought total shame to the office of the municipality and the chairperson.
Another citizen, Nelson Fernandez, objected to his acting as a courier for the Margao MLA when he is from Fatorda constituency.
The chairperson of Margao Municipal Council chose the platform of the council meeting to to pronounce his innocence in the Jaika matter. He had very clearly stated on that day that his role was only to collect a letter from his MLA and take it to Panjim and bring it back. I failed to understand whether this chairperson has started a courier service of taking letters from MLA to Jaika office and from Jaika office bringing it back. Okay. Number three, I failed to understand why the ex-chief minister and the MLA, sitting MLA of Margaon, chose only Arthur.
For Prime Video journalist Aditya Bidre, Margaon. Reacting to the opinions voiced by San Andreas MLA Vishnu Vagh against casinos, GenNex President Durgadas Kamath has said that then opposition leader Manohar Parrikar had said that prostitution and abortion cases had gone up in Panjim in view of casinos. Kamath also argued that now BJP MLAs who were earlier silent on casinos were coming out against casinos after GenNex exposure about the casino fraud. GenNex President Durgadas Kamath said that the statement of Manohar Parrikar can be verified from the records of the Goa Assembly. Has the abortion suddenly stopped after the BJP came to power? He questioned.
31 March 2011, Bab Manohar Parrikar, tenna jo punya jo amdar ani virodhi paksha neto ane ek statement kelle on the floor of the house records kadun payat ki पणजेन ताजो कोण एक मित्र आहा दोतोर आनी ताणें ताका सांगलां की एबॉर्शन केसी वाडपाक लागल्यात आनी हे एबॉर्शन केसी वाडपाक लागल्यात कॅसिनो खातीर म्हणून म्हणल्यार थंय सगळे इलिगल एक्टिविटीज चलतात म्हण ऑफशोर कॅसिनोंचेर आतां सत्तेर आयल्या बरोबर भारतीय जनता पार्टीक दिसून आयलें की एबॉर्शन अचानक बंद जाल्यो काय थंय धाडे घालतकच बॅगां पावपाक लागलीं म्हण एबॉर्शन बंद जाल्यो हें तांच्यांनी सांगपाची गरज आसा 2011 31 March हो विधानसभेच्या फ्लोराचेर स्टेटमेंट केल्लो आहा की आपल्याक आपलो एक मित्र आहा पणजेचो दोतोर ताणें सांगलें की आपल्या कडेन केसी वाडल्यात काणयो सांगपाक हुशार न्ही हे लोक सो आज गोंयच्या लोकांनी जागृत जावपाची गरज आहा की कशे तरेन भारतीय जनता पार्टीन लोकांक फसयल्ले आहा.
He strongly objected to the sites proposed by the government to relocate the offshore casinos. Kamath lashed out at the BJP government for fooling the people by saying that they are relocating the casinos. Goa is not a place for casinos and they need to stop immediately as the lives of youth are at risk.
Ata ye je decision zala pehlo casino jo license khopta 29 August tak sarkar notification katta public opinion magun 15 days pehli. हे हाजेरूच एक पण स्पश्टपण जाता की हे सरकाराचे ढोंगीपणां चालू जाल्ले आहा ते ढोंगी बाबा कशे आसतात पळय तशें हे सरकाराचे ढोंगीपणां चालू जाल्ले आसात कारण जेन्ना तूं शिफ्ट करतलो पब्लीक ओपिनियन मारून एक जागो फायनलायज करतलो थंय इन्फ्रास्ट्रक्चर क्रिएट करपाची गरज आसता जेटीज क्रिएट करपाची गरज आसता जे 15 दिसांक किंवा 2 दिसांनी उबे जायनात सो हे सरकाराची सगळी एक चाल आहा की हे कॅसिनोज जे आहात पणजे मतदारसंघानूच दवरपाक आतां हांव मागतां उलो मारता पणजेच्या स्वाभिमान नागरिकां कडेन जे स्वाभिमानी नागरीक आहा पणजेचे हांचे कडेन मागता की जशें साकवाळ ते सापोरा पर्यंत लोक उठिल्ले आहा पणजेकारांनी आतां उठपाची गरज आहा तुमचो लढो आमी लढयतले पूण आमकां उठात आनी सपोर्ट करात आनी जे एंटी कॅसिनो एक्टिविस्ट आसा जे कॅसिनोच्या विरोधांत लढो दिवंक सोदता आतां तांकां सगळ्यांक आमी अपील करता की जेन नॅक्शन हो लढो पयलीं पासून घेतिल्लो सगळे आमचे पॉलिटिकल डिफरन्स आसूं येता कितें आसूं पूण विशय आहा तो एकूच हांगा म्हणजे कॅसिनो.
For Prime Video journalist Praveen Marathe, Panjim. Two Ayush hospitals, one each for North and South Goa, and National Institute of Naturopathy and Research Center for Ayurveda were announced by Minister of Ayush Shripad Naik while speaking at the press conference of International Youth Day.
7,000 youth from across the state will participate at the International Youth Day at Dr. Shyama Prasad Mukherjee Hall on 19th August. The aim of the program is to make Goan youth and the people aware about HIV and AIDS. The theme of the International Youth Day 2015 is Youth Civic Engagement.
आम्ही 4 प्रोपोजल आमच्या गोंयचे तयार करतात पहिले म्हणजे एक दोन्ही डिस्ट्रिक्टात साऊथ गोवा आणि नॉर्थ गोवा एक आयुष हॉस्पिटल एक नॅशनल इन्स्टिट्यूट ऑफ नॅचरोपॅथी हे एक जातले आणि सेंटर पणजे आणि पणजे आसपास रिसर्च सेंटर फॉर आयुर्वेदा ऑल इंडिया रिसर्च सेंटर फॉर आयुर्वेदा आता 100 बेडाचे हॉस्पिटल जॉईन असतले रिसर्च सेंटर झाले. रिसर्च सेंटरात जमीन गव्हर्नमेंटान रेटिल्ली असा की चिंबल एक हेल्थ मिनिस्ट्रीची जमीन असा हेल्थ डिपार्टमेंटाची ती जातली आणि दोन्ही डिस्ट्रिक्ट हॉस्पिटलाची जमीन ऑलरेडी फायनलाइज झाली असा. जी नॅचरोपॅथी इन्स्टिट्यूट येतले नॅशनल नॅचरोपॅथी इन्स्टिट्यूट येतले ताका 100 बेड हॉस्पिटल प्लस नॅचरोपॅथीची कॉलेज येतली हे धारगळच्या हातूंतल्यान ताणें दाखोवचे म्हणला. आता 4 प्रोजेक्ट आतां हेतून आसा ते लगेच ताजे आमकां जी जमनीची एनओसी दिली त्या
प्रोजेक्टाचे.
An HIV mobile app giving information about HIV and AIDS will be launched on the occasion, where Chief Minister Lakshmikant Parsekar will be the chief guest. Deputy Chief Minister Francis D'Souza, Sports Minister Ramesh Tavadkar, Vishnu Wagh and other dignitaries will also be present for the function.
पहिले सेशन जे उद्घाटनाचे सेशन जातले 11 सुरू जातले ते 1:00 सोपतले आणि 1:00 सोपल्यानंतर मागीर 2 सेशन असतात. ती टॅक्निकल सेशन आसात. पयलीं सेशन आसा हें सोशल प्रोटेक्शन ए स्टेप टुवर्ड्स अ सेक्युअर फ्युचर म्हणून ताजेर लॅक्चर जातले 2-3 हें चलतले. दुसरे सेशनान ड्रग यूज HIV एन यंग पीपल अशें दुसरें सत्र जातलें. तातूंत युवकांक ह्या संदर्भांत HIV एड्साच्या संदर्भांत मार्गदर्शन मेळटलें. त्या नंतर एक सांजचो सांस्कृतीक कार्यक्रम जातलो.
फॉर प्रायम व्हिडिओ जर्नलिस्ट प्रवीण मराठे पेंजेम.
Now let's take a break. The news continues on Prime.
To test the Gillette Mach 3 Turbo, we put Leo Messi's face through a season of harsh conditions. Then we ask him to shave.
To prove our advanced lubrication technology better than this disposable for a close and comfortable shave with less irritation.
No matter the conditions you face, Gillette.
Welcome back. The Goa High Court Bar Association in its extraordinary meeting on Monday decided not to host farewell dinner for Chief Justice Mohit Shah of the Bombay High Court, who retires on September 9th. IRIS has urged Bombay High Court Chief Justice Mohit Shah not to attend the dinner party by the Goa government on August 20th in view of the austerity measures orchestrated by the government.
Advocate Iris Rodriguez in a press conference on Tuesday has stated that the Goa government has no funds to pay the monthly pension payments for the last 2 months for needy old age pensioners under the Dayanand Social Security Scheme.
So now the Goa government has decided to host a dinner for him on the 20th of August at the Marriott's. I have today written to the Honorable Chief Justice Mohit Shah and explain to him the reasons why he should not be attending such a dinner by the state government. Firstly, the Goa government does not have the money and has not paid Dayanand Social Security benefits to the old age pensioners for the last 2 months. If a government doesn't have the money to pay pension to the old age pensioners, it doesn't have any right to be squandering lakhs of rupees on this state dinner for Chief Justice Mohit Shah. Spending money on this dinner is very inappropriate. It is also for the first time that a dinner is being hosted for a sitting judge. I have requested Justice Mohit Shah not to stoop to that level, as it would also send a very wrong message. I've explained to Justice Mohit Shah in my letter that there is a public perception that the judiciary in Goa, the independence of the very judiciary in Goa, has been compromised.
Rodriguez questioned how the throwing of dinner would go on with the government trumpeted economy measures. He called for a total restraint on wasteful expenditure in tune with government's pronouncements.
In view of the manner in which he has over the years treated the advocates in Goa and being disrespectful of the interest of the associations in Goa. So in view of this, all the facts are now placed before Justice Mohit Shah, to whom I have faxed the letter this morning.
for Prime Video journalist Saif Sheikh Panjim.
The practitioners of homeopathic and Ayurvedic systems of medicine on Monday demanded that they should be allowed to undertake integrated practice as done in 8 other Indian states. This will give them the right to practice allopathy to the extent of the training received by them in their respective systems of medicine, they argued. Doctors practicing in alternate systems of medicine are based in rural areas. Unlike the allopathic doctor Sankli MLA, Pramod Sawant informed, pointing out that in emergency cases, when the need for prescribing allopathic medicines arises, the Ayurvedic as well as homeopathic practitioners should be allowed to do so. We have already submitted a memorandum to the government in this regard and expect a related bill to be tabled in the House in the next session, Sawant added.
कि इंटिग्रेटेड प्रैक्टिस कर भेदवार तक वैक नहीं कारण इंटिग्रेटेड प्रैक्टिस कर पाक इंडियन आता पर्यंत जवळपास 8 स्टेटी ने अलाउ केले असा एंड इन आल्सो गोवा स्टेट वी हैव डिमांडेड टू गिव अस फॉर द इंटिग्रेटेड प्रैक्टिस आम्ही ऑलरेडी एक्ट रेजोल्यूशन सेपरेट करता असताना आम्ही नवीन भितर अमेंडमेंट ही केला असा की आमका इंटिग्रेटेड प्रैक्टिस करपाक अलाउ करचे आणि आमका खात्री असा की दिल अलाउ अस त्या खातीर आमची रिक्वेस्ट असा फॉर द FDA ऑल्सो एंड द डायरेक्टरेट ऑफ हेल्थ सर्विसीस ऑल्सो सिन्स फ्रॉम द पहिलीपासून इंटिग्रेटेड प्रॅक्टीस करीत आयिल्ले असा त्याच्या खातीर परत एकदा आयुर्वेदीक डॉक्टर्स ज्यांच्या जे सिलेबसान इट इज इंटिग्रेटेड मेडिसीन असा सो दॅट टू द एक्सटेंड ऑफ द ट्रेनिंग वी हॅव रिसिव्ड इन अवर सिस्टीम ते आमकां अलाव करचे कारण बरेचसे प्रॅक्टीस तर दोज आर प्रॅक्टिसिंग इन द पॅरिफेरी एरिया वेर देर इज नो ॲलोपॅथीक डॉक्टर्स इज प्रॅक्टिसिंग दॅट्स वाय वी आर रिक्वेस्टिंग टू गिव्ह अस to practice in allopathy, integrated practice.
We have requested the government that there should be separate acts as well as boards for both Ayurveda and homeopathy, Sawant added, informing that the government has already favoured his demand.
आतापर्यंत गोवा बोर्ड ऑफ इंडियन सिस्टम ऑफ मेडिसीन अँड होमिओपॅथी काउन्सिल ॲक्ट 2001 हो एकूच आशिल्लो ते सेपरेट करचे अशी डिमांड असा फाटल्या असेंब्लीत हाजो रेजोल्युशनही हांवें मांडलेलो सो दॅट ऑन द प्रॉमीस ऑफ हेल्थ मिनिस्टर ऑलरेडी हांवें तो बॅक घेतला बट हेल्थ मिनिस्टर आमकां प्रॉमीस केला की ते सेपरेट करता.
फॉर प्रायम व्हिडिओ जर्नलिस्ट प्रवीण मराठे पॅन्जिम. Shiroda MLA and Industry Minister Mahadev Naik has said people should cooperate to complete the pending Rashol-Shiroda bridge. Naik stated that the government is making every effort to complete the bridge during this 5-year tenure. Naik, who was speaking after inaugurating a function in Rashol on Tuesday, said that the Rashol-Shiroda bridge will be completed without taking away any land from the Rashol farmers.
त्यांची कोऑपरेशनची गरज आहे. तांचे भितर कितें गैरसमज जातले जायत आनी कितें जालें तें मातशें पयस जावपाक जाय तसो प्रयत्न मुखारले काळा भितर करूंक पळयता. म्हजो खूब प्रयत्न आसा कितें हांव तेंचे सहकार्याचे कॉपरेशना अपेक्षा करतां तें मेळत जाल्यार बरें जातलें की पूल हो जावो हो अत्यंत गरजेचें आसा तें समजून घेवपाक जाय कोणाक बादीकारक जाता कोणाक त्रास ना हाली मातसो विषय बंद नाशिल्लो तो परत तुम्ही चाललो म्हणून
धोक्याचे निर्देशन झाले त्यांना तो विषय येतो रेग्युलर पेरला ते किती म्हणून रस्ते विषय काय सारखे ना तर कोण म्हणते
रस्ते माझे वटेन सारखे असतात
यासाठी सारखे
म्हणून हय ते रिजनलान पळोवपाचे हे वटेन रस्ते करपाचे काम आमदार म्हणून त्याचे आणि माझे वटेन तू आयल जायत न्ही तुका 98% असते वॉट मिक्स दिला अख्ख्या शिरोडा.
It may be recalled that the local Kurtoli MLA Alesso Reginaldo Lorenzo, along with the Rashol and Raya villagers, had opposed the bridge, claiming that the construction of the bridge would damage large tracts of cultivable land. It also would affect the fishing activities of the locals. For Prime Video journalist Aditya Bidre, Margao. The High Secondary and College Lab Attendance Association has alleged harassment at the workplace by managements of respective institutions. They allege that the Goa Board of Secondary and High Secondary Education has failed to take cognizance of the matter, so they have now moved the Industrial Tribunal. The association has also demanded 6-hour working hours as per government notification.
Association President John Moniz said the lab attendants are harassed by institutions and are forced to do overtime with no extra payment. No safety equipment is given to them in the laboratories and they are told to sweep the classrooms corridors, etc. They allege that they do not get holidays for Ganesh Chaturthi, Diwali and other festivals.
We have written many letters to the director regarding harassment of our employee members, but till date he is not supporting. This shows that the director is hand in glove with the management, and with his blessing they are doing all this. They have been harassing our employees. Harassing workload, they are given overtime to work. Some of them are told even to work during Ganesh holidays.
The issue was initially with chairman of Goa board J.R. Ribello, who said the board cannot look into the matter. The management too refused to look into our grievances, forcing us to approach the Labour Commission and then Industrial Tribunal, Monish said. For Prime Video journalist Praveen Marathe, Panjim.
In view of 5 malaria cases detected in the Rajtoli Batwadi ward in Mapsa, municipal councils held door-to-door awareness campaign on malaria and to eradicate the breeding of mosquitoes with the support of Mapsa Urban Health Centre.
The councillors, along with the health department doctors, visited the families of the ward and took the blood samples to find any cases of malaria. They also distributed pamphlets and instructed the residents not to allow water to accumulate since it allows mosquito breeding. They also sprayed insecticides on all the accumulated water and cleared the stagnant water.
Hanga sir, jawajaw 5 cases detect zalle asa. Ani hamen ye mananiy amche amdar ani mantri aha, deputy minister ani health minister. Tancha kanar 15 August aisa tancha kanar gatla. Ani tyanantar ami healthanui sangle, municipality ku sangle. आणि आज ही सगळी आम्ही आणि मलेरिया ज्यांका येईला ते वक्तानूच त्यांचे क्रिया आता क्लिअर जातले बरे जातले ते आता अवेअरनेस करपाक जाय तर वाढोवचो न्हू वाढपाक दिवपाचो न्हू ह्या खातीर आम्ही हेल्थाक तसे म्युन्सिपाल्टी बरोबर घेऊन आयच हो कार्यक्रम केला कार्यक्रम म्हणजे आमचे कामच आहे.
फॉर प्राईम व्हिडिओ जर्नलिस्ट श्याम सुंदर फट्टे, मापसा.
3 persons were arrested and 2 girls rescued in a raid by police at Model Status Donapala near Goa University.
Upon receiving a tip-off, the Goa police raided the premises of Model Status and arrested Afran Ahmed, Mohammed Shabir and Mohammed Imran of Mumbai, Kolkata and Jharkhand. 2 girls who were rescued were sent to protective home at Mersey's. Investigations are in progress at Panjim Police Station. 2 bikers met with an accident at Hotel Top at Davli Ponda at 7 a.m. Tuesday. The victim, who died on the spot, was studying in an open school while the other rider was injured. Bureau Report Prime.
A male body was found floating in the Mandovi River in front of the old GMC building on Tuesday morning. On intimation, the fire emergency services fished the body out of the river. A case of unnatural death was registered by the police.
Eyewitnesses, however, stated that the person was mentally unstable and was taken into police custody on several occasions regarding various complaints. Some injuries were noticed on the face of the deceased. For Prime Video journalist Praveen Marathe, Panjim.
Mail us at newsprimegoa@gmail.com or WhatsApp us on 9637969244 and give us your feedback about this newscast. That was the news for you. Thanks for watching Prime. Take care and goodbye.